Hi, welcome to Lessons with John. Today we're going to let the sun shine in from hair. Alright, I'll teach it to you two different ways, okay? This is the key that they're in the song. It's got some chords that aren't quite easy. About halfway through the video, I'll show you an easy way to play it, okay? So, B minor, you bar the second fret, and then the fourth string, fourth fret, okay? This is part of a kind of a larger piece of music. It's like three songs in a row near the end of Hair, and this is the finale, and they just keep doing it over and over again. And what I did, I just focused in on Let the Sun Shine In, because I like that song, and the other two I could do without. So sometimes they put Aquarius from Hair and Let the Sun Shine In together. I didn't do that yet, but I just focused on this one song. I found that the progression was so easy that I just had to do it. So there you go. So B minor we gave you, okay? Then the F sharp 7, second string, second fret, fourth string, third fret, and then the third and first string at the fourth fret. That's an F sharp 7. And then the only other chord you need, the two chords you need is a G, which is your third string, second fret, first string, second fret, and second string, third fret. And then the D chord, fourth string, third string, second fret, open first string. Those are your four chords in the original key, okay? The progression is a B minor to an F sharp 7, F sharp 7, back to B minor. Then the G to a D. And that's it. That's the progression. And it just keeps circling around, okay? Let's see, what can I tell you? So the strum pattern is pretty complicated. What I'm doing is, it's down, down, let me try that again. Down, 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 up, up, down, 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 up. So that's without muting the strings at all, because you hear me going sometimes. So it's like, I do that on the B minor, and then on the F sharp 7, I do it two times, B minor once, G once, D once, and then we cycle around again. Let me show you how to put the chickens in. So I'm going to go down, down, and then my third down, I'm going to release the pressure of the chord, but keep the chord down and get this sound. So it's like, and I put the pressure back down for the up, and so I got down, down, and that was a down up. And then when I get the next section is up, down, down. So I mute the first up and then down, down pressure. And then at the end, it's a down up, which I mute both of them, just like that. So real slow, it's like down, down, up, and then up, down, down, and then down up. So you got down, down, release, down, up, and then release, up, down, down, and then release, down, up. So hopefully you can catch on to that. Now, if you don't want that pattern, you can do something easier, certainly. But that's what they're doing. You know, the electric guitar seems to be doing something like that. Also, at the end, you could just hit, you got to end it somehow, right? What they do with the D chord is like, and then they pull it off. It's kind of hard on the uke to do, but. So let me show you. I'll do it through one time, and I'll just end it this time. So B minor, F sharp 7, back to B minor, G, and then down, down is your D, and that's your ending. All right, so we're going to simplify it a little bit. So we're gonna do an easier strum pattern, and the chords will be easier too. So this is A minor, fourth string, second fret, okay? And then E7 will be our next chord. Fourth string, first fret, third string second, first string second fret, open second string. And then the F chord is the second string, first fret, fourth string, second fret. And then you need a C chord, first string, third fret. Everybody else is open. So those are your four chords to make it nice and easy. Now, if you just have to be in their key, just put a capo. If you can't play those bar chords and stuff and those complicated chords in B minor in that key, put a capo at the second fret, which I'm not going to bother to do, but but you could. Put a capo at second fret, and you'll be right in the key of B minor using the A minor shape. All right, so let's you could do it the complicated strum like this, A minor to an E7, E7, back to A minor, then an F to the C, and then you repeat. If you want, you could make like a folk version out of it, so it's nice and easy. So just do your strum where the most popular one we use is the down, down, up, up, down, up. And then F to a C. One more time through. A minor to an E7 chord. E7 chord back to A minor. The F sun comes in and C. So that's an easy way to play it, okay? And then at the end, you just hit C when you want to end the thing. So there you go. There's a simple way to play Let the Sun Shine In. All right. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and play more Ook.